Hello, hello, my name is Jani. Welcome to my channel. This is a cross stitch channel where we talk about cross stitch. And this time I want to share with you some happy mail, some whips, and a wonderful finish that I just, you know, I just finished this project a few hours ago. So yeah, I'm really, really happy to share with you this, you know, this result. So if you want, we can, well, my name is Jenny. I am a Mexican stitcher. I love to record these videos, to make these videos. I do videos in English, not my native language, and in Spanish, and I really, really love to share my love for cross stitch. So yeah, if you like to watch my videos again in English or in Spanish, it's fun. I'm always so grateful for this lovely community and the possibility that you gave me, you know, sharing this journey and getting motivated by you, and at the same time trying to be, you know, a factor for you to start new projects or to keep stitching, or we can stitch together and we can learn and we can teach each other. So yeah, it's a wonderful, wonderful community. Thank you again. As I always say, I like to be thankful for this opportunity. So talking about being thankful and having these amazing stitchy friends, I received a couple of gifts, and I want to share with you, you know, these gifts. as beautiful friend from Spain, my friend Sacra sent me this lovely booklet of samplers, and I'm so in love. And it's so interesting because a few years ago I was not really interested in this type of design, this type of samplers and, you know, letters, and it was something that I didn't, you know, feel connected, or they didn't appeal to me. But right now, as it's very interesting how we are evolving in our method to stitch, and the same happens with our preferences, with you know, the designs that we choose to stitch right now are different from the one that we used to stitch when we start. So I am loving these designs, so classic, so elegant, and as I say, originally I didn't really thought much about this, but right now I feel, you know, so inspired, and I am loving this. So one of these design is this lovely sampler with the roses here, and I love this little doll. I stitched 1/1, even though it's not my favorite, but I really need to stitch this project and this lovely border. So yeah, I'm so in love right now. So I'm going to, the flosses are all DMC, but I'm going to make a conversion, trying to respect the you know, general aspect of this design, but I will be using some variegated silks and, you know, different flosses. And yeah, I'm really, really excited for start this project next year or next week. But yeah, this is a booklet, is 15 abecedaries, floris. It's a French, you know, magazine or booklet, and I love it, I love it. All the designs are so beautiful, you know, so girly and so elegant, very much not like me at all, but right now I'm in that point that I feel girly and elegant, you know, in my sweatpants. And I'm going to stitch this particular project with silks, with different silks, and you know, the MC and perhaps flosses that I dyed myself. And I'm going to use this Lugana 32. I'm going to stitch it 1/2 because I love the look of a Lugana 32 with one floss, you know, a really thin crosses. And this was originally a white Lugana, it's a Lugana 32, but I coffee dyed this and it looks so nice. If I say so, but yeah, I really, really love, and I really, really happy to start this project. And some of the other gifts that I received is a pattern by Mirabilia. It are these lovely mermaids. The design is Twisted Mermaids. This was a gift from a dear friend that I meet on one of my cross-stitching retreats. Vero, thank you very much. I love this design so much. And she also sent me the Lugana, so. And I'm really, really happy for this design. It's a beautiful Mirabilia. And I am really thinking on start this project. You know, one of my tiny mirrors, because I'm going to use this almost 38 fabric, but I really want to use this fabric with the two colors, trying to place the mermaids in, you know, each color of the fabric. Perhaps not exactly, but you get the idea. And even though the colors of the fabric are very similar to the design, I think they are going to look really coordinated and really nice in this fabric. I don't know. I just thought they would look really pretty here. So we'll see. We'll see. I will let you know. And even though, as I said, the colors are really similar, it's the same what you can really see. But Cathedral, also by Mirabilia, the color of my fabric was really similar to the color of her dress, but the project looks really pretty. So yeah, even though the color of the fabric, it's very similar to the color of the design, I think this will look just very pretty. I don't know. But perhaps I can make, you know, this experiment. And talking about experiment, I was visiting yesterday some friends, and their mom used to have a needlepoint, or yeah, needlepoint store. So she have, you know, a few flosses. So I see these rayon flosses, you know, these silky flosses, really, really beautiful, really slippery to stitch with, but the colors are so pretty. So I decided to choose you know, colors similar of the Mirabilia from the design. I don't know if I will use this for a stitch, the Mirabilia, but look at these shiny colors. It looks like a little, you know, bouquet of flosses. With these silky flosses on their tails, I think they will look so pretty. I don't know. I don't know. Perhaps I can use some of them to stitch the mermaids. I let you know. But yeah, I'm really, really happy with this possibility. And also another gift that I received a few days ago is this planner, 2022 planner, a beautiful design by Lori Holt. This is the box. And I was not really, you know, used to get, you know, a planner and have my projects write it down. And this year I started with this planner that one of my girls got me, one of my daughters. And yeah, I have been, writing my plans and projects and having really fun with it. So I'm really happy to have this new 2020 planner, and I'm going to start making plans and following, projects and perhaps changing things and trying to be more organized and enjoy this process. So if you want to get this beautiful planner, it's so pretty. Look, with all the months, and you can put notes and, as a planner. But it's so pretty. I'm going to let the link in the description box. Thank you so much to Fat Quarter Shop and to Lori Holt for this lovely gift. I love it. And the box, it's so pretty. I'm going to put all my new flosses in this box. Amazing. So happy for these gifts. So yeah, really exciting about plans for 2022, starting new things and keep stitching on my whips. And I'm not really a rotation stitcher. I, stitch what I want, whatever I want. But interesting enough, I'm a monogamous stitcher, because when I'm stitching, a project, I try to finish it. Well, usually. But yeah, I can be, you know what I mean. I can be stitching, for example, in a week, two or three projects, different projects. I need to be focused on one project, two at the most, but usually just one project, and then I can, finish the project or get tired or bored, so I change the project. But being stitching one day in one project, the next day in another, I feel a little anxious about it. But yeah, we all have different methods and different ways to approach our stitching. So yeah, I'm really a monogamous kind of stitcher in that way. Not in the sense of having just one project, because I have more than 100 perhaps. I'm really happy about it. So yeah, another project that I want to be working next year. Let me find let me up here. This last week I saw this wonderful project by Old Forest, a black sampler. Amazing, beautiful. It has the three elements, the sea, the earth, and the air, the sky. So it has a little mermaid and a sheep, and then a house, and elements from earth, and then a balloon from the air. It's so lovely. I love it. I love it. So I was thinking, because it's a monochromatic sampler, but of course you can choose different colors or add as many colors as you want, or just use one color. So I decided to look for a floss. This is a sewing floss. And I really like this type of floss for monochromatics samplers, because first, they are really cheap. You get a lot of material, and this is a polyester floss. But again, I really love stitching with CXE, which are polyester, and this color is so pretty, and I love it. I love it. And they didn't have this in black, which is the color of the black vintage sampler, but I have to have this red. And I, even though I try with a piece of my hand-dyed fabrics, which is this one that I love. It's like this vintage, dirty fabric, and I start these little crosses here with the red floss, just to see the coverage. I use one floss over two threads of the fabric, And I really like the coverage because I can see the shape of the cross, and it's really comfortable. But definitely, I didn't like the look for this project. So yeah, sometimes you have to, have that perspective of say, perhaps not for this time. But I love the fabric and I love the floss. So I'm going to use this piece of fabric in another sampler. I love it. I love it. This fabric is so pretty. And I'm going to use this wonderful red color in a red sampler. But I'm sure I'm going to use this in a white fabric. So the wonderful color of this floss can really, stand up, and I think in a white fabric this floss is going to look amazing. So I'm going to keep this floss for another project, another red sampler. Who knows? Who knows? And I also got this sewing floss in black, but it's not as shiny as the red one. This is more matte. But yeah, this perhaps again for another project. We'll see. We'll see. But again, I still have that problem on where to start my black vintage sampler. So I had this fabric that I dyed. It's like this golden yellow butter color. It's really pretty. And I decided to start with a CXC floss 1/2. This is 38, sheesh, 36 cotton fabric that I dyed. But I think the contrast between the black floss and this yellowish fabric is going to look amazing for this pattern. So yeah, this is my star, my little star, just to check. So I'm going to stitch with CXC, and I need to get, a lot of skeins of CXC because it's a really big project, but it's lovely. So I can't wait to keep stitching on this project. So yeah, I found my combo for this project. And another project that I've been working on is Quaker Welcome by Lila's Studio or Lila's Studio. And this project, I haven't stitched much these few days because I was finished the start of the video, but I really want to finish this project before New Year's, so I can show you as my last project, my last finished project of the year in the video of the my year year's review. So hopefully I can finish this project. Next week I'm going to be only focused on finish this, and I don't have much done, but it's not a difficult project. This is my progress. And of course I change the word welcome to bienvenidos in Spanish. So yeah, I am really, really loving stitching on this. This is a project that I really love. Every time I watch or I see another stitcher with this project, I die a little of envy because it's so pretty and I really want to stitch it. And I have, a few months with this, and I say, just stitch it. So I'm using the call for materials, but I'm stitching the black part, not with the gentle art, which is like a dirty black, like a really, really, really dark gray. But I am using CXC in black because I really like that color. And the fabric, it's a 36 even weave that I coffee dyed and then I bake it. to give these, marks, and I really love it. So yeah, let's hope that next week I can finish this because it's so pretty and I really want to finish it. And finally, I want to show you my finished project. I didn't frame it because I didn't have a frame big enough, and I really want to frame it, properly with a really nice frame. So I'm going to buy a frame specifically for this project. But this is a design. This is a project that I got on 2005. So this is a project that it's almost 18 years old with me. And I was really, really exciting when I got this kit, the pattern with all the silks and all the flosses and the beads and the metallics. And I got all this, remain material that these are the silks that I'm going to use for the sampler with the doll. So yeah, I'm going to use part of these materials in my next project because working with silks is amazing. And I love this silk so much. And I always try to keep my projects in their individual, project bag with all the materials, with the fabric, with the flosses. And in this case, these are projects that have more than 15 years with me. In this case, almost 18 years with me. And if you keep it in a project bag with all, in order, you don't have any problem or any issue with the project. I also have some of the metallics that I use. I have like four remaining. I don't know why they include so many, but this material, again, I'm going to use it in several projects. When I got the kit, they send these little, like tins, and they are so cute. And I remember that when I got each of these, because they are like eight or nine little, tins, or containers, I drop one because they don't close properly, and I was, oh my God, I dropped one of the beads. So I jump to the floor and start, gathering the beads because I said, where I'm not going to order more and I need to save all the beads. So yeah, it was a little scare, but I put all the beads together, and at the end I didn't have, any missing materials. On the contrary, I got a lot of remaining material, remaining silks. But that's basically because when you got a kit from European cross stitch, they send you the full skein of silk. So if you are going to use just, a few crosses if you're going to stitch a few crosses in the design, you're going to end with almost a full skein of silk. So, but that is not necessarily a bad thing. For example, in my case, I'm going to use most of this in my next project, and I'm sure I will be using all of these materials eventually. So I'm really happy to have this little stash of beads and metallics and silks. So happy. And I remember when I ordered this kit that I was really nervous about it because it was my first time, one of my first time with Chatelaine designs and working with silks and making specialty stitches, and I was really anxious. And I wrote an email to Martina, asking her about, advice and about the color of my fabric, about using these specialty stitches, and I was afraid to use the silks, and she wrote me an email that I keep it here with the rest of the kit, where she was encouraged me about the use of silks, and to have to enjoy the process, and to seek help on the Chatelaine group. And she even suggests a color for my fabric, and I keep that email that she wrote me with all my love, because it's a special detail and a special token by Martina. And she leave us with these wonderful designs, and I am fortunately enough to have a few kits and a few whips, and to being able to stitch these projects, it's always a joy. So yeah, I'm really happy. And with this particular design, I'm over the moon. This is Misty Morning Vineyard by Martina Weber. It's stitched with the call for materials, silks, metallics, crystals, and I stitched this on Lugana 28, an opalescent Lugana. Opalescent is not my favorite fabric to work with, because the fiber that gives this shiny effect sometimes gets in the way of your needle when you are doing the crosses, but the appearance and the look is so beautiful. So yeah, perhaps not one of my favorite fabric to stitch on, but I love the look. So yeah, this is Misty Morning, and as usually with Martina's design, you have a central motif, and then you start to work to the outside and repeating motifs, and sometimes you get tired of, in this case, the peacocks and all the corners and all the flowers and the specialty stitches that you have to do two times and then four times and then eight and 16. But it's an amazing experience. This is a project, again, that I started many, many years ago, and sometimes I felt overwhelmed by all the specialty stitches and all the beads and the metallics and the details, and to have to follow the instructions according to the design of Martina sometimes was stressful. But slowly, as I said at the beginning, you start to change the method that you stitch, the way that you look at your stitching. And this last corner, that was the last corner that I did in this month, was such a joy to stitch. I don't know if it was because it was the last part, but I was not worried about following exactly the pattern or following exactly the colors of each specialty stitch, or perhaps a specialty stitch was not the correct one in that space. But I really, really was enjoying my stitching and enjoying the freedom of having this wonderful piece in my hands, and being able to stitch the way I like to stitch. I start this piece in the center with a frame and with all the equipment, and it was almost a ceremony before I start stitching this. And right now, in this last part, I stitch on hand. I stitch everywhere. I could be, at a coffee shop, in the park. I took my stitching, and I enjoy that experience and that opportunity. So yeah, this last corner is perhaps different from the rest of the corners, but it looks the same, and the joy that I have with this last part is much bigger than the rest of the design. I allowed myself to enjoy my time stitching this piece, and at the same time I was thankful for the for all the experiences that we share because there were so many years and so many things that these pieces have from ourselves. So yeah, try to learn to enjoy this opportunity and enjoying each stitching and all the things that you can learn, and don't miss this opportunity. Sorry for the emotional thinking, but yeah, we let so much of ourselves in the pieces that we stitch, and it's always amazing to have this opportunity, and especially in these difficult times, that we have the chance to you know, in the middle of all this chaos and all these problems, we can take a piece of fabric, some flosses, and create something beautiful. So yeah, again, so thankful for this. And this is my report for today. Hopefully I will record a last video for the year with all my pieces of 2022. I hope to finish a welcome Quaker, but if not, it's okay. So yeah, take care of yourself. Thank you as always for all the joy and all the things that you let me share and we can learn together. Take care of your family, take care of yourselves, and I will see you in my next video. Bye-bye.